Good morning, class. Welcome to our chemistry lesson today. And we are continuing with our revision on the topic mole. Last time we did a question and I asked you to continue preparing this area, still emphasizing that this area is very important in our KCSE examination, paper 1, paper 2, paper 3. So we are moving on very well. And today we want to look at these questions on the board. The first one reads 20.0 centimeters cube of 1.2 moles per liter hydrochloric acid was used to neutralize 16.0 cubic centimeters of sodium hydroxide solution. Determine the molarity of sodium hydroxide solution and hence find its concentration in grams per liter. We are given the atomic mass of the elements, and therefore I want one of you to identify the known concentration here. When we were discussing mole, we said you will use the concentration of the known solution to find out the concentration of the unknown solution. So can we identify the known concentration here? Correct, hydrochloric acid. Because we are given the volume and its molarity. So therefore, this will help us to find the concentration of the unknown solution. So let's work out the number of moles of the known solution, number of moles of hydrochloric acid solution will be given by the molarity 1.2 multiplied by the volume in liters. Remember, you must convert your volume in cubic centimeters per liters by dividing by 1,000. So we have 1.2 multiplied by 20 over 1,000. So this will give us what value? 0.024 moles. It's the moles of the known concentration, that is hydrochloric acid. Now from here, we need to know the mole ratio of the acid to the base. You can write the equations, right? You can write the equation or you can use the mole ratio. Let's write the equation. Hydrochloric acid reacting with sodium hydroxide, which will give us sodium chloride and water. Again, this is a neutralization reaction. I say it, a neutralization reaction is a reaction where an acid reacts with a base to give us salt and water as the only products. For this, our mole ratio is 1:1, and therefore, number of moles of sodium hydroxide solution will be the same as the moles of the acid, since the mole ratio is 1:1. So because the mole ratio is 1:1, therefore the number of moles of the acid will be the same as that of the base. Next is now to work out the molarity of the base. We are given the volume, which is 16.0 cubic centimeters, and already we have the number of moles. So molarity of sodium hydroxide will be given by moles, 0.024 liters. You divide by the volume in liters, 16.0, and then you multiply that by 1,000. So you take the number of moles which we have obtained from this mole ratio over the volume. And the volume must again be converted into liters. Let's work out the get the answer. Yes, somebody to give us the answer. 0 point. Not 0 point, it should be 1 point. 5. The units is capital letter M, which stands for molar or moles per liter. So we are 1.5 moles per liter. The next part of the question says, and hence find its concentration in grams per liter. Concentration in grams per liter. So therefore we need to work out the formula mass of the base. So the hydroxide will give us information here. So it will be, what is the relationship between molarity, relative formula mass, and the mass per liter? So we know that concentration in grams per liter will be given by, we need to have the relationship between molarity, mass per liter, and relative formula mass. So we know that molarity will be mass per liter over the relative formula mass. Molarity can also be given by mass per liter over the relative formula mass. So therefore we are looking for this. So the mass per liter, because we know this and we know we can work out that, so it will be given by molarity times the relative formula mass. Molarity multiplied by the relative formula mass. Then, so the relative formula mass of sodium hydroxide will be 23. You add 16 and 1, that will give you 40. And therefore, mass per liter, concentration in grams per liter, will be therefore 1.5 multiplied by 40. The concentration or molarity multiplied by the relative formula mass, and do that accurately, that will give you 6. Mass or concentration in grams per liter will be 60, and that is our answer. Concentration in grams per liter. And say grams per liter, because the same with the question asks us in grams per liter, then you don't need even to include the units, because already the question says answer in grams per liter. So that is, so first use the information of the known concentration to find out the number of moles. Then from there, I have the equation which will help you get the mole ratio. And from this, the mole ratio is 1:1. Therefore, means the number of moles of sodium hydroxide reacting will be the same as the number of moles of the acid. And from there, now we work out the molarity of sodium hydroxide, that is in moles per liter. So the number of moles divided by the volume in liters, and you get 1.5. And then now relationship between molarity, mass per liter, and relative formula mass is that molarity will be given by mass per liter over the relative formula mass. And our relative formula mass in this case is 40. The molarity is 1.5. So therefore, concentration in grams per liter will be the molarity times the relative formula mass, giving us 6 as our answer. Let's move to question number 2. It reads, when 34.8 grams of hydrated sodium carbonate, whose formula is given here, sodium carbonate, and X molecules of water crystallization, were heated to a constant mass, 15.9 grams of anhydrous sodium carbonate were obtained, but made the value of X in the hydrated carbonate. Now we have hydrated that which has some water crystallization, and then anhydrous is one without water crystallization. So first, we are given that 4.8 grams of the hydrated sodium carbonate, and then it was heated to a constant mass, and we are 15.9. So we need to work out the mass of water. So mass of water, because when heated, you are driving away the water. So the mass of water will be 34.8 minus 15.9. To get the mass of water, you subtract the mass of the hydrated salt minus that of the anhydrous carbonate. Now, when you do this accurately, you will get, yes, 18.9 grams. So that's the mass of water. Then now, we have this table. Compound, we have sodium carbonate, and we have water. Mass, these are the compounds. Yes, mass of this is 15.9, and mass of water is 18.9. Let's get the relative molecular masses. We work on that of sodium carbonate. That would be 23 times 2 plus 12 plus 16 times 3. That is 46. This is 48 plus 12, that is 60. We get 106. This is 106. That of water is 1 times 2 plus 16, which is 18. We get the number of moles. Number of moles, we say, we divide the mass over the formula mass, so it will be 15.9 over 106, and this other one is 18.9 over 18. Let's work out and get the values there. What is 15.9? We divide by 106. Get 0.15. This is 0.15. Then 18.9 over 18 gives us 1.05. Correct? Okay. Then the next step is to get the mole ratio. Mole ratio you divide by the smaller. Now we compare 0.15 and 1.05. This is the smaller. So therefore, mole ratio. Say you divide by the smaller. So you have 0.15 over 0.15. This other one is 1.05 over 0.15. Get the value there. You will get 1, 2. This is 1. And this, you do this accurately to give you 7. So then, this 7 is the value of X. The value of X. So the ratio of sodium carbonate, the anhydrous to water is. Therefore, now you are told to convert the value of X. So the value of X is 7. Meaning, the number of molecules of water in this compound is 7. The number of molecules of water of crystallization is. If you are told to write the formula now, the correct formula of this compound, then it is Na3O7 water. We call this sodium carbonate 7 water, or sodium carbonate What is we have these pumps. We have 5 or 10 penta, 6 for hexa, 7 for hepta. So if you are told to give the name of this compound, though we are not asked, then it is sodium carbonate heptahydrate. Seven, so it has 7 molecules of water or crystallization. Or you can simply say sodium carbonate, 7 water, it's acceptable. Good. Any question up to the class? So first, work out the mass of water that was lost when the compound was heated until this constant mass is obtained, which is for sodium carbonate. We know that from effects of heat on substances, we know that the salts of the carbonates of sodium, potassium do not decompose. So even if you continue heating this for a very long time, you will only lose the water of crystallization, but the compound does not decompose because it's a stable salt. Therefore, the mass obtained is that of water. Then use these steps to find out the value of X here. Good. Now, question 3, I will leave this for you to discuss, and when we meet in the next lesson, we will get the responses from what you have. Thank you. Have a pleasant day.